Hi everyone, I'm CK from Blake Records. As promised, I'm going to make a video sharing with you the sound system in my house. Now, I'm not exactly an audiophile, I'm more like a vinylholic. I enjoy crate digging, buying vinyl records and collecting them. But over the years, I know that it is still important to have a respected system at home to enjoy those music and those wonderful recordings from my vinyl records collection. So today, I'm going to show you the sound system that I have, and over the years, what other equipments I have used. I probably would like to share that as well. All right, let's go. Okay, I'm going to first start off by talking about the source I have in my sound system. As you know, I'm very much an analog guy. I don't own any CD player. I don't have a DAC. So the only source I have at home is my turntable. And I'm currently using the Torrents TD-550 turntable. This is the flagship turntable from Torrents. I got this not a brand new set. In fact, I got this as a pre-owned set. I'm happy to find one of this set in one of the shops in Singapore, in Adelphi, a shopping hub for all the audiophile people. And this Torrents TD-550, I've probably just opened this up here. It has a very nice, and I always will remove this protector case when I listen to my records. Now, as I say, this turntable comes with a special limited edition tone arm. This is made by Da Vinci from Switzerland. All right, this is a very nice tone arm. And it's a very nicely built turntable. I like the look. In fact, it's the look that actually caught my attention. And of course, I did a little bit of study, read some reviews, and also listened to it with a lot of music that I like. And I probably like this, and I upgraded this, my previous turntable from a Project Perspex, or 6 Perspex, to this Torrents TD-550. Now, it comes with 2 speed. As you can see, the indicator here, these are the buttons for the speed, 33 RPM and 45. In fact, behind there is a little knot at the rear there where you can actually control and adjust the speed as well. And if I turn it on, you can see it also has a Torrents blue light indicator. And also the whole metal plate here makes it gives it a signature look. It's reflective. You can see my son is actually taking the video now for me. All right, and I'm using the Transfiguration Protus S cartridge. It's a fantastic cartridge. The stylus is from Japan. It's a flagship stylus from Transfiguration brand. It's called the Protus S. The characteristics of the sound is very natural sounding, very transparent. I really love this cartridge. I probably will be keeping it as long as it lasts. All right, that's all for my source. I'm gonna just move on to my phono stage. Yes, this is my phono stage that I'm using. It's a phono stage from UK, and the brand is called Avid Audio. This is in fact their flagship phono stage unit. It's called the Pulsar 2. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Pulsar 2 phono stage, and it's actually a 2 unit set. The bottom unit is the power supply, and the top unit is the signal section. What I like about the Pulsar 2 phono stage is that it comes with the knobs adjustment on the exterior, on the front panel. As you can see, I'm just zooming a little bit for you to see it clearly. It has an input selector here, and it comes with the gain, the resistance, and also the capacitance adjustment knobs. And this gives me a lot of flexibility to make those adjustments so that I can match it to the stylus that I'm using, which is very critical. And it's good always to have the separate power supply. By separating the power from the signal section, it will actually means that it will has a lower noise and distortion. And also by having a separate power supply, it actually gives the unit a higher current drive capability, which means it can equate to higher fidelity of the sound coming up from the unit. All right, and I didn't buy this new. I was lucky again. I got this as a demo set from a shop in Singapore. I got this probably for about half the price, half the price of the list price. And the list price currently in Singapore, I haven't checked it, but it's probably going around 9 or 10K Singapore dollars. The price, of course, may vary from country to country, depending on currency, and also depends on the country taxes. Alright, from the frontal stage, let's go down. Oh, this, I'm not using this. This is actually a preamplifier from a Taiwan brand called Usher. I've used this previously, probably quite a number of years ago. I've used this together with the matching power amplifier, and it's quite a cost-effective set. And after that, actually, I moved on to upgrade it to a Macintosh MA7000 integrated amp, where I got it from a good friend who actually let his unit go to me in a very good price, friendship price, in fact. So I've been using the MA7000 Macintosh integrated amp for a while. There's a story behind it. One day, as I was listening to my favorite music, smoke starts coming up from the amplifier, and I was thinking whether to repair it or to trade in and get a new one. So eventually, I decided to trade in for this unit. Yes, this is the my new integrated amp. I've been using this for about a year. This is the Accuphase. Again, this is from Japan. The Accuphase E650 integrated amplifier. All right, this is a Class A amplifier. I love the sound of Class A. Class A amplifier has a lot of advantages when it comes to the dynamic range. Of course, the disadvantage of a power amp is that you have to be careful when you match it to a speaker. The power coming up from one of the channel to 8 ohms for this unit is 30 watts. The sound of the Class A amplifier, those who are using a Class A probably will agree with me. It's very detailed, and I like the mid range that comes up from this, especially when I match this with my Focal Sopra speaker. I really love the richness in the mid range, the details that it produces, the dynamic range that this Class A amplifier gives is really phenomenal. All right, I enjoy my Accuphase a lot, and I believe there are a lot of Accuphase lovers out there as well. So do share with me comments about how you have been enjoying the Accuphase system that you have. All right, now it's time to check it out, my speakers. Let's go.
Okay, so let's take a look at our Focal Sopra speakers. We actually had a family meeting to decide on the color of our speakers, and I managed to convince my daddy to get the orange color because I love orange and I just find that it brightens up the whole room.
Yeah, initially I thought my son would get the white color set because the white color really looks like a stormtrooper from Star Wars, because you can see from his t-shirt here he's a Star Wars fan. So I thought he would get the white color, but good choice there. And mommy approved it, so I'm happy to get these bright orange speakers, which really, like what my son said, brightens up the whole house. Okay, look wise, we really like it, but what about the sound? Those who own a Focal speakers will probably know that Focal are well known for its characteristics of being more detailed, more analytical. So people who like a more natural sounding speakers or speakers that are more musical, the Focal might not be exactly your cup of tea. Now, the Focal speakers, the Sopra N2 comes with some new technologies. I will not go through those technologies in details, but basically it comes with a very a high-tech mid-range driver, okay? The Beryllium tweeter. This is probably the signature tweeter from Focal. They like to use the Beryllium tweeter, which actually gives it a very high frequency precisions in terms of the sound. That is what Focal speakers are so detailed. It also comes with a 2x7-inch woofer, right? This is the 2x7-inch woofer. I like the bass of the Focal. Some people think that the Focal not really good in this bass, but if you have heard the Sopra N2 before, you
In the
will know that it
bass,
has fantastic bass. Am I
and it
right?
has a rumble.
It has a rumble, yes, and it's punchy. And most important, it's fast. All right, and especially the music that we hear, this rock and punk music that we hear, we need
We need
fast
bass.
bass speakers to deliver the kind of feel that we want. All right, so this is the Focal Sopra N2. We love these speakers. Previously, I'm using a PMC, a UK PMC OB1 speakers, which is quite different in the sounding. It's a more natural sounding speakers, but when we upgraded it to the Sopra N2, We can't say which one we prefer, but it's very different sounding. This is more analytical. It gives us a lot of details in the music that we play. Some people might think that the vocal, you get tired, you know, after listening for a while. Especially for people who prefer a more natural, more musical sounding speakers. But if you like analytical, you like details from your speaker, from your sound system, then
you should get this.
Yeah, you should check this out. All right, okay. We're gonna go to talk a little bit about the interconnects or the cables that we have. We don't really invest a lot on the cables. We do a little test. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we did a little test. Yeah, we actually chose three speaker cables to test. One from Audience, the brand called Audience, and the other from AudioQuest and Inacoustic. All right, and then my son is involved in the test as well. So, we did a little family project.
So we listened to my favorite song, Bohemian Rhapsody, on all three cables, and I wrote down like some of the comments on a notebook, and I gave them a score out of 10, and we chose...
Yeah, Inacoustic. All right, so we decided to go with the Inacoustic cable. The model is 1204A. Probably in the 2K range, that's the price range that we have. And to go with it, we have the matching interconnects also from Inacoustic. All right, and I believe it's the 16, cannot remember the number, but it's 1604 RCA connectors. And also, I've forgotten about the isolator. We also have isolators to support the speakers. And in fact, I have a box here to be sold you. This it's the brand that we got, the Isoacoustic brand. All right. I probably don't know how to pronounce this. The Gaia one. Okay. Isoacoustic isolator. All right. To provide more stability, to reduce the vibrations of the speakers. What else we have missed out? I think we covered wrong. And I'll cover this one. Introducing this. Of course, for analog guy like me, cleaning your cartridge and stylus is important. So I highly recommend this electronic stylus cleaner. All right, if you can take a look inside, this is how it works. Okay, you have this solution and you can just put one or two drops of solution on this part of it. And then when you turn it on, it's basically give a gentle vibration and you can just drop gently your stylus on it and it will clean it. And it is important, of course, to have your stylus clean regularly so that you to protect them as well as to deliver good sounds out from your records. Alright, I think, why don't we play some music?
Yeah.
Alright, one thing you probably have not, especially all the audiophile people watching this video, is that we did not get our room treated. So there's no treatment in our room. Probably from where I speak, you can hear quite a bit of echo in it. So this is something that we hope to work on in our next stage. We're gonna do some treatment to the room. But at this moment, there's no treatment. So when you hear the sound coming off the speakers, yeah, you probably think that it's a bit of echoish, so it's not perfect yet. So we hope to work on the treatment. Any advice on doing treatment, do leave us a comment as well. Alright, let's play some music.
Well, you can cry.
play it for you. We are just recording it using our phone, so probably it doesn't sound as great. But anyway, we understand that we will need to do some treatment to our listening room. We're probably considering getting some diffuser, some bass strap, so that the room is properly treated and we can bring the best out from our system.
Thanks for watching our video. Thanks for sticking all the way to the end. And if you like the video, please click the like button down below. And we will really appreciate it if you subscribe to our channel.
Yes, and we hope to see all those comments and feedback coming. And we're going to make some more interesting videos in the coming weeks. And hope you can subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much. Thanks for sticking with us. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.